Hey everybody, how you doing? It's Michael Bashi here again, and welcome to another video. And in today's video, we are going to talk about how to scale your solo ads business. And I know, don't be jealous, I know my handwriting is sexy as hell, so just, you know, keep your shirts on. Anyways, I know my writing sucks. Anyways, here's the deal. There are a couple things you need to be aware of in terms of scaling your solo ads business. Now, scaling by definition can mean anything you want it to mean. Okay, so what is your desired income? So, I mean, and I don't like putting numbers on things, but in the sake of demonstration, I'm going to kind of have to. So let's say you want to make $5,000 a month. You want to make $10,000 a month, $100,000 a month, $100,000 a year. You want to make a side income of $1,000 a month, $2,000 a week. As you can see, I'm giving you random numbers by daily, weekly, monthly, annually, it doesn't matter. So your desired income is your personal desired income. And based on that, by you knowing that, you'll be able to determine how far you want to scale your solo ads business. Now, the beautiful part about selling traffic and starting an advertising agency, specifically with solo ads, you could scale it to as high or as low as you want. It all depends on how much you want to make. Now, there's a few key concepts that I am going to talk to you about in this video that you need to literally come to terms with, comprehend, understand, get over it, and just basically do it. And the reason why I say get over it is if you have a hard time getting over some of the stuff I'm going to mention in this video. So what I'm gonna give you in this video can be applied across any business, online business, when it comes to scaling. Okay, but specifically, I'm going to focus some of the details on the solo ads business. So this is why I say to get over it, because regardless what you are doing, if you somehow stumbled upon this video, whether on my YWTA blog or on my YouTube channel, based on what your purpose of watching this video is for, will determine what you have in your mind as to what you think about when you think of scaling. And the stuff I'm going to mention are things, if you have not come to terms with yet, you just need to get over it, because what I'm going to show you is what works. So specifically honing down on the solo ads type business, when we think about scaling, if you are already a YWTA client, then inside the members area in the customer nurturing section, so your scaling will be predetermined by how accurately you followed the customer nurturing part of the training. Okay, and the reason why I say this, because you need to understand this, with an advertising business, well, and let's say specifically with solo ads, the way to make a lot of money, and when I say a lot of money, as I was saying earlier, that is basically determined by what your desired outcome is income-wise. So when I say scaling and desired income, again, it could be 50 grand a month, 50 grand a year, 2,000 a week, it's your own decision. But whatever goal you have can be achieved with this business model. So the way to make an advertising agency, the way to scale or to determine how much you want to make, and specifically with solo ads, is by how closely of a relationship you are developing with the few customers you are getting. So here is a key concept you need to comprehend, and if you can't, you need to get over it and comprehend it. With a solo ads agency business, the way to scale and the way to make a lot of money is by having a few key clients that keeps buying from you over and over and over again. Because here is how it works. If somebody, let me give you the general concept. If somebody buys traffic from you once, if they like your traffic, if it was quality, if it converted for them into leads and sales, they have no reason not to buy from you again, and they have no reason not to trust you. Hence, every time they buy from you, they will buy larger packages, okay? And they will buy from you more consistently. And that is all determined, okay, whether you're gonna reach that far with each individual client or not, is how closely is your relationship with them? How well have you nurtured them? Okay, so that's a key concept that you need to think about, okay? And that's why it's very important you follow the training, specifically the customer nurturing part, which is the follow-up and making sure your client got everything they want and that they're happy. And if they're not, you try to somehow accommodate, because your end goal is to turn as many of those clients that or customers that buy from you on the lower end, you're trying to give them the best value, the best customer service, so that they buy from you over and over and over again. So here is how this goes. Let's say, and this is why it's hard for me to give numbers, because every client that comes in and starts their solo ads agency, they come in at different advertising budgets, they come in at different motive, different personal drive. Each one of them is running this business to accomplish something specific or something different financially. So every person's goals are different. So whatever I say here, it's all like general. So let's say your goal is to make $10,000 a month. You want a $10,000 a month business, specifically running your solo ads agency. So let's say through advertising, depending on how you want to advertise, whether you want to do free advertising, whether you want to do paid advertising, pay-per-click, social media, YouTube, LinkedIn, however you want to drive traffic to your business, to your lead magnet, generate leads, and then turn those leads into solo ad customers, however you want to do that. Okay, and each person, depending on their experience, their aggressiveness, where they start, how much they listen to and follow the training inside YWTA. So the more you watch the training over and over again, the more experienced you will become. That's what I mean by experience. So let's say you're one of those who are actually, you know, you invested into YWTA, myself and my team built the business for you, we gave you the training, you're taking it seriously, you're gonna follow what we say, you're not gonna give up when something doesn't go your way, and your goal is to make this work because you know what works, we've shown you what works, there's proof that it works, and you are determined to make $10,000 a month. So let's say you have discovered that for every 300 visitors, let's say you are advertising, whether free or paid, it doesn't matter, but you're driving traffic to your business. So let's say hypothetically you discovered that for every 300 visitors, you send to your website, for every 300 visitors, you get about, let's say for example, 100 quality leads who opt in to your funnel, who opt in basically to the funnel that we built for you. The numbers are usually higher than this, but I'm just being conservative, and I'm assuming, let's say you're gonna do Facebook ads or pay-per-click advertising, and hypothetically you're paying $3 a lead. I'm just assuming. So I'm doing high numbers here and being conservative at the same time. So let's say you spend $1 a visitor. So let's say you spend $300. And again, I'll explain something to you about budgets later. So let's say you spend $300 to get 300 visitors. Out of the 300 visitors, 100 opt-ins, 100 leads, which means you paid, let me change the color here, which means you paid $3 per lead, okay? And you discovered that for every 100 leads that you get, that you pay $3 for, you have 5 customers who purchases a solo ad traffic package from you. Now, we are here assuming that these are all brand new customers that are coming in for every 100 leads. So 5% conversion rate, usually it's about 8 or 9%. That's how it works for a quality lead that you're getting from a quality source. So let's say about 5 customers. Okay, that are buying, let's say, your lowest traffic package. And as of the recording of this video, the lowest traffic package is $44. So you get 5 customers who purchase the lowest traffic package, which is what most of them do. They usually go between $44 to $88 just to test you out. So let's say you get 5 customers at $44. Okay, and let's say out of the 5 customers that purchases once from you at the lowest package to test you out, they purchase a $44 package, okay, we're going to assume that one of them, that one customer, will become a, let me do this here, will become a loyal client that will buy in traffic combined, depending on how he buys or she buys the packages, whether 500 clicks, 1,000 clicks, it's always different. But let's say on average, one became a loyal client who is buying traffic from you at approximately about $1,000 a month, okay? Maybe one day they buy $200, next week they buy for $400, and then they buy for, you know, $500 or $600. So, but on average there, it's this, every client is spending about $1,000 a month, okay, with you. Maybe let's say when you have more loyal clients, you know, maybe one of them will buy $800 from you a month, the other one will buy $1,200. But on average, let's say $1,000 a month. So now you know your math. You know for every $300 that you spend, okay, you're going to get 5 customers, and you are going to get 5 customers at the low end, and you're going to get one loyal client spending about $1,000 a month. So the math I'm trying to demonstrate to you here, and basically this is kind of paints you a picture on what's important and what you should really be focusing on, okay? So what you should be focusing on is, so let me tell you what most people focus on, which is irrelevant statistics and numbers. And people think the more data they have, the better. Like most advertising networks, they confuse you with too much data, but there's only a couple numbers that actually matter, okay? And what actually matters is how much are you spending and how much are you making on average through a lifetime. So what's your lifetime customer value? That's what really matters, okay? Because let me tell you this. Most people, they worry. This is where most people's attention goes. Most people's attention goes here. How much visitors they got, how many leads they generated, and how much each lead costed them. Okay? Now, let me tell you this. If you know every time you spend $300, you gained over, let's say, a period of about 4 weeks, okay, every $300 turns into one loyal client who is buying about $1,000 per month of traffic from you. So for every $300 you put in, you are getting on average about $1,000 per month in residual income. Sounds amazing, right? So you're putting in $300, you're getting $700 back profit, and then you're profiting from that $300 on average, not always going to be $1,000, but on average, you're averaging $1,000 a month from each client. Now that you know this, would it really matter how many visitors the $300 are getting you? Would it matter how many leads the $300 is generating for you? Would it really matter how much each lead is costing you? Okay, would you care if $300 only got you 50 visitors, only got you 10 leads, and each lead costed you, let's say, $30? Now you're paying $30 a lead, but the end goal is still the same. $300 is netting you one loyal client at an average of $1,000 per month. Okay? So on the flip side, most people focus on this. Oh my God, I spent $300. Oh man, last time I got 300 visitors, this time I only got 50. Oh my God, my cost per lead went from $3 to $10. Oh, this campaign is not working, shut it down. And then they stay on that hamster wheel of spending too much money, okay? Scattering their focus all over the freaking place without focusing on what's actually important. Because at the end of the day, if your funnel works and your funnel is profitable, and specifically we're talking about YWTA, I've tested the living crap out of the funnel and it works. If you stay consistent and you follow it and don't worry about the stupid things like this type of stuff, and just worry about how much money you're putting into advertising, whether it was in dollars or whether it was in time. So this could be time invested or money invested or both, because we do have a way to get clients by doing free advertising where it involves manual labor on your part. And I teach you paid advertising to get customers, leads, clients, the whole thing, basically the whole nine. So don't focus on this. This is what you need to be focusing on right here. So now that we know this, okay, let's say hypothetically $300 a day or a week or a month is all you can spend. Okay, so now you need to know that it's going to take you longer to get to $10,000 a month, because it's going to take you basically, let's say, 10 months to get to $10,000 a month, because you can only afford to spend $300 a month on advertising. Let's say for somebody else, it's going to take them 10 weeks to get to $10,000 a month because they can spend $300 a week on advertising. Let's say somebody else, it's going to take them 10 days to get to $10,000 a month because they can spend $300 a day. Now, keep in mind, these numbers are not always going to work out in your favor. Some days, some weeks, some months, maybe you'll spend $300 and you'll make nothing. You're not going to get a loyal client. But on average, that's where consistency comes in. On average, if you keep the engine running, you keep the funnel going, you keep traffic coming and more leads are coming in, the more you stay consistent and you don't pause, you don't stop your advertising, you don't advertise when you feel like it, because you're building a real business here, the longer you keep it going, that consistency will make these numbers accurate and work in your favor. Consistency is everything, guys. I talk about this word in almost every single training video I make. Consistency is everything. So now your budget and how much you will make and what your goal are is determined by this right here. And this is one of the key reasons why when somebody asks me, how much do I have to spend to make this much? I can't really give you a definite answer. And especially in our industry, when you can't give a definite answer when asked a question like this, okay, the potential client of mine or to anybody will think, oh, you're being shady, or you're lying to them, or oh, you're trying to twist and turn to not give a direct answer. Well, I'm sorry, but you cannot give a direct answer, and I explained why. Because there are so many factors involved, okay? And I don't know you, personally, I don't know you that well, so I don't know what your desires are. I don't know what your commitment is. I don't know what your drive is. And you telling me you're very committed, that's not enough. That doesn't help, okay? Action proves, action are stronger than words. So when I see that you're actually doing it, I'll know you're doing it because you're gonna report your results to me. And you're gonna tell me what you're doing and how much you're making. That's how I know you're driven. You're gonna make it work. But the people who complain that it doesn't work, then I know that it's not this business because it's been tested. If it worked, if we're building the same concept, the same funnel, giving the same teachings and the same trainings to the same people, and some of them are succeeding and some of them are not, then obviously the problem is not with the system. The problem is with the person operating and following the system. Okay? Systems don't fail, people fail. If the system is perfected once and it works, the system will always work unless something breaks in the system. In this case, it's the funnel and the business model. But it depends on the operator who is operating the funnel, if they're doing it or not doing it properly. Okay, and that is something that comes over time. And expect to fail. And until you get it, until you learn this business, and that's normal. This doesn't mean that this stuff doesn't work. It just means that you're working hard to make it work because, let me put it to you this way. If your goal is making $10,000 a month, okay, hypothetically, that's $120,000 a year, okay? Doctors, certain doctors make about, or lawyers, they make about $120,000 a year. Now, these doctors and lawyers, they go through 8 to 10 years of schooling, and they know they have to sacrifice. They know they have to, you know, leave their parents to go study abroad. They know they have to go to different colleges. They know they have to, you know, crash and rent rooms and sleep with next to people that they don't want to sleep next to. Let's say they're not comfortable using the same bathroom as somebody else. They have to go through exams and tests and study and eat junk food. And basically you go through all that sacrifice to then get a piece of paper that's going to make you $120,000 a month. And then you leave. And once you're at that stage, most students have debt. And all of that equates to sacrifice. Okay. So why are we okay with coming to terms with that type of sacrifice, but you're not willing to spend, or people are not willing to spend 3 or 4 months just to stay persistent and consistent with this stuff to start making 10 grand a month? Because people have this illusion that online business is something that is just magical. You just go online and billions of people will see you and everything will just work because it's the internet. It's all, you know, fun and rainbows and candy and chocolate. And no, that's not how it works. Okay, the sacrifice for doing this is this much, okay, when compared to what I was explaining to you of becoming hypothetically doctor or lawyer. And the payout with this stuff is tenfold compared to hypothetically becoming a doctor or a lawyer. However, most people are not willing to go through that, but they're okay to go with what's harder. Okay, like it makes sense to them. So I hope this kind of like opens up to what I'm trying to say here. Okay, because this stuff works. Okay, and I know I get off on specific topics, but everything is related to everything. So now, after I've given you all these lessons and I explained all this stuff to you, now we talk about this magic word here, scaling, okay? So now that you know this math, okay, now scaling becomes easy. It becomes the fun part. You know, on average, $300 gives you $1,000 per month in residual income on average. So you wanna scale to $10,000 a month? You know, you gotta dump $3,000 to get to $10,000. You know you have to dump $30,000 to get to $300,000 a month, okay? And then you can scale to as much as you want, okay? And again, all of this will work, and it's predetermined by how well you nurture every customer that comes in. Because out of every five that come in, according to the numbers we're doing here, when you nurture them properly, you should get at least one of them to become a loyal client. Okay, paying you at whatever average of what they buy at. If you discovered that your, let's say, hypothetically, if you discovered that with the same math, okay, you're gonna get each loyal client, okay, let's say with the same math, everything is the same. Just that's why I always tell you that for each client it's going to be different, because that's just the way it works, like for each YWTA client. So let's say you discovered that with the same math, that for every $300 that you spend, you're getting five customers who buy the low-end packages, and then let's say only one of them again becomes a loyal client. One becomes loyal, okay, but they're only buying about, let's say, $300 a week. Okay, so not $1,000 a month. You did your math where you notice that on average you're getting, I get excited and I start to write funny. Okay, $300 per week. So they're spending about 12, so they're investing with you about $1,200 a month. Okay, now this changes everything. This changes your entire math. And then you go that way. Okay, so now you know for every 300, you're getting about $1,200 per month, or you could go $300 per week on average. So now you know 600 will get you $2,400. $1,200 will get you $4,800. So now you know the math, but again, consistency is what will determine this. So again, folks, this is how you scale your solo ads business. And so what you have to know before you even start any of this is, what's your goal? How much you want to make, whether it was a short-term or a long-term goal, and your goal can change later. But whatever goal you make right now, you got to stick to it until you reach it. So if your goal is $2,000 a month, $3,000 a month, I just give you the $3,000 per month guarantee, okay? Because on average, if you do what I am telling you, okay, even if you're not getting any loyal customers, if you keep doing what I'm telling you, you should be making about, let's say, $1,500 a month. Okay, on top of this, adding, you know, one or two loyal customers, if that's all you get, period. Okay, not a month, not a week, just two loyal customers, period. With the one-off sales from new customers that you get, plus the two loyal customers, on average, you should, you know, make about $3,000. Now, 1 month it could be $2,800. Another month could be $2,000. The next month could be $2,900. The following month could be $4,000. But on average, you should average at about $3,000 per month, give or take. Again, if I was to tell you, nope, 100% guaranteed $3,000, I would honestly be lying to you. So I hope this shed some light and it made you understand what scaling is, how scaling works. And it's not just about, oh, scaling and I'm gonna just, you know, this is how much I want to make and I'm just gonna dump more money on traffic. It doesn't work that way unless you have few key components in place, which are the predetermination of the customer nurturing training that I take you through and teach you, and also by knowing what your goal is and testing and sticking to whatever advertising you're doing, whether free, paid, what platform, what channel, doesn't matter, but you stick to it and you stay consistent. And once you know your numbers, you'll know how to scale. Without knowing your numbers, you can never ever scale, whether it's this business or any other business. It really does not matter. Okay, and one other point I want to bring up as to the difference between, let's say, selling advertising and selling how-to products and courses and coaching and so on, is that when you're selling how-to trainings, it's a lot harder to scale. Because when you're selling a training or a how-to or an access to a membership area, you're basically relying on one-off sales. Because if you have a training program that you are selling, okay, and that training program that you are selling, let's say costs, let me just delete this really quick. Let's say the training program you are selling costs $197, okay? Let's say it costs $197. That's how much you're selling it for, okay? So now, every customer that comes into your door that ends up buying, you're making $197, okay? But there is only so much how-to you can sell. When that customer buys from you once, you don't have anything in your business model here that's going to make them pay you again and again and again for the same service. Because when they pay you $197 for your how-to course, it's not like they're gonna pay you that every single month. They're gonna pay you that once to get access to the course. Now, yeah, you might have updates or annual fee if you want the newer updates and so on, and that's great. But imagine instead of a one-off sale of $197 and then you have to work so hard to either sell something else or offer other programs or other trainings and to try to get more sales out of the same person. Imagine if you don't have to deal with any of that headache, and imagine the customer paying you over and over and over again becomes a no-brainer, where let's say instead of buying a how-to course for $197, let's say you're selling let's say you're selling 300 clicks, hypothetically, for $197. When the clicks run out, they're gonna wanna come back and pay you another $197 for 300 more. Next week, they come back and pay you another $197 for 300 more. A month later, they come back and they pay you maybe $500 for, let's say, 600 clicks, and so on. So the same customer keeps on paying you over and over and over and over again without you having to create a new training program, without you having to add some updates to your how-to course to get them to pay you to get the updates, without having to make any discounts and without having to get any new customers. That's why selling advertising is so much easier, because the same customer can make you as much money consistently in residual compared to, let's say, on average, like hypothetically 10 customers who are buying one-off how-to courses from you. That's why the advertising is so much more powerful, so much more effective, and so much more profitable. So I know I went a little bit broader than scaling, but I hope this gives you as much information as possible that you need to know about scaling any business online, solo ads business specifically, well, advertising and so on. It's a lot easier to scale because there is more money in it. Okay, so that's the end of this lesson. I'll see you guys whenever you either send me an email letting me know you need to learn something, or whenever I see that the market is in need to learn something else, I'll make and shoot another video for you guys. Until next time, Michael Bashi here. If you have not checked out YWTA, you need to go ahead and check it out. If you're not a client, if you have not checked out the free 20-minute training on the two core elements, so just go to yourwebtrafficagency.com and /solo ads, or you can just go to yourwebtrafficagency.com and you'll be taken from there. And if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll be able to click a link in the description of this video that will take you right to that page, and you can register for the free 20-minute training. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll talk to you guys next time I shoot a video. Take care. Bye.